Now in section 1.4.2 we will discuss cylindrical polar coordinates. We discussed already the spherical polar coordinates for spherical geometry. Now in physics we are having cylindrical geometries as well. So for that we want to design a specific or related coordinate system so that our calculation is easier in such a coordinate system. Now the cylindrical coordinate system is very easy and simple compared to the spherical polar coordinates, and let me design the figure to draw this one. So this is our axis x, y and z axis. Let's say this is our x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis here. And let's say we are having our vector, which is in the Griffith it is denoted by S, while we can represent this with the R as well, but to differentiate with the spherical polar coordinates is better to use S as per book. Let's say this is our vector R, vector S in this plane. Now this vector is having projection on the xy plane is here, means this angle is equal to this angle. So I can draw this one here, and this is having a projection vector along the xy plane here, and it is this one. So it will have two components here. On the x-axis it is this much, and on the y-axis this much. So this is the x component, this is the y component, and parallel to this one this is our x component. And let's say its projection is making an angle pi with the on the xy plane, and is this is the at this point we are having the unit vectors, and the unit vectors are such that we are having this is the z unit vector, this is the z unit vector, and then the phi unit vector will be inside here like this. The phi is going here in this way, so this is phi unit vector, while the s unit vector will go this way, and they are all perpendicular to each other as we have done for the spherical polar coordinates. So this will be the vector, and this is the these are the unit vectors. Now what goes on here, the very first, let's say we are having our s unit our s vector which starts from origin and reaches some length, and that length is s. Then that s will make a circle on the xy plane, and that circle we rise z distance up in order to make a cylinder. So these are the things here, that our s will actually runs from s will run from 0 to infinity. There is no restriction on its upper limit. The minus infinity is unnecessary to have because we are having a positive radius here, while phi will go from 0 to 2 pi, means it will make a complete circle, while z can extend in both ways from minus infinity to plus infinity. It can extend in both ways. Either it can go up to make a cylinder or can go down to make a cylinder. So we are having these are the limits of this to make a cylinder, and we will now derive the x, y, and z component here is for any vector r in three dimension, as we covered in spherical polar coordinates. We have written the any vector r in Cartesian coordinate is equal to the x in x unit vector plus y in y unit vector and z in z unit vector. Now in the Cartesian coordinates, we are having x, y, z, and we converted earlier them to r, theta, and phi, and now they will be converted into s, phi, and z. Now we can note here that the cylindrical coordinates are having only one angular component and two length components. So that's why it is comparatively easy to work with the cylindrical coordinates. Now here, when I consider this is the projection, so I can write the magnitudes of this. This means this S here I consider here. So it's the same S here, and we will have the two components of it. This will be means the base here. So this is the X component and this is the Y component, and I can write that the X component will be S time cos of phi, while the Y component will be S time sine of phi. So I can write that X is equal to S times cos of phi, while Y is equal to S times sine of phi. While the Z component, this S is having, it's in the plane here, so it is having no Z component. If I consider this is the Z component, so this, the Z component remains as it is, because we will then raise that circle up to that length along the Z. When it will make the circle on the XY plane, we will rise it up to the Z. So this is our coordinate. These are our coordinates. So I can write that based on this one, I can write R vector equals X is equal to S and cos phi and the X unit vector plus S times sine phi and the Y unit vector and plus Z and the Z unit vector. So I have written R in terms of X, Y and Z here from this very simple diagram. And now we can find the components, means the S unit vector, the phi unit vector and the Z unit vector. One thing is for sure, the Z unit vector is along the Z unit vector, so it will remain the same, while we will write the S unit vector. So the S unit vector, if I come here, then this is having two components. This is the component which is the S sine phi along the Y axis, and then this is the S cos phi which is along the X axis. So I can write that the S unit vector from here, the S unit vector will be, let me write it here, the S unit vector is basically equal to the S vector divided by the S magnitude. We know this thing, that S unit vector will be equal to this, and now here means divide this one. This is the S. Okay, let me write this as S because we are having the S here, not R here. So S will be equal to divided by the magnitude S, and this is equal to cos phi in X unit vector plus sine pi in y unit vector. And then what about the z unit vector? The s is having no component here, it is in the plane of x and y, so this component will be equal to zero, and we are left only with this. So I can write that s unit vector is equal to cos phi in x unit vector plus sine phi in y unit vector. And now what about the phi unit vector? The phi unit vector is, we have already done this thing in the spherical polar coordinates. It will be again the ds vector over d phi divided by ds vector over d phi, and this will be the magnitude of it. Means the variation of the s vector with respect to phi, and this is equal, we can then write this thing that this is basically the variation with respect to d phi of the s unit vector, and just differentiate that with respect to phi, and this will imply that the phi unit vector is equal, its derivative with respect to phi, minus sine phi plus cos phi, and this in y unit vector and this in x unit vector. So it will be equal, the phi unit vector will be equal to minus sine phi plus cos phi in y unit vector, while the z unit vector is equal to the z unit vector. It is in the same, means only one here, so it is in the same direction as it is. And now we can calculate the length elements here, and the length elements are, when this is our s vector, this is our s vector, this is the s vector, and this s vector will be changing in ds, means the change in s vector will be ds along the s unit vector. So I can write that the fraction, means of the length element, which I will call dls, that will be equal to ds here. Similarly, what about the other vector? So the other vector is such that I can write that this is our vector s, and now when this vector shifts here, means let's say here, when this shifts a little bit d phi, so it will make, means like it just moves d phi here and here, means this just moves by d phi here, so it will make an arc here, but is the, this is a perpendicular component. If the phi is very, very small, like d phi means the smallest fraction of phi, so then this arc will become is a perpendicular distance, it will become is a line, and we will write the dl in phi is equal to s times, means it will be equal to s times the angle which is sine of phi, and is for phi very, very less, then sine phi will go to phi, and as we are having the phi equal to del phi, so it will be equal to s d phi. as we have done in the spherical polar coordinates. I am doing the things simply here because we have explained these things in much detail in spherical polar coordinates. So this will be just like over there we were having r d theta. Here we will have s d phi. So our dl phi is equal to this, and dlz will be equal to z itself, and it is just the fraction displacement on that side. So I can write that the area, I will multiply any two dimensions. So we can have the area like the dA1 here. The dA1 will be, if for example we are having the product of dLS and the product of dL phi, then this will be in the z unit vector, and dls, this will be equal, dls is equal to ds, and dl phi is equal to sd phi. So this is equal to sds d phi in the z unit vector.